Hi, I'll be making upma dhokla. Yes, you heard it right. Upma dhokla. It's like combining two dishes and making one terrific dish. So to start with, I'll just take some water in the steamer. I have to fill it less than half. While the water is getting hot, I'll prepare the batter. I'll be using the MTR upma mix for this. With this one packet, you can make a whole lot of dishes. This is one of them. I'll add about half a cup of curd to this. Half a teaspoon of cumin. A pinch of hing. Some chopped green chilies. Little bit of grated ginger. And finally, about half a teaspoon of salt. Batter. Usually we make upma using this mixture, but in this I'm making dhokla. I think it's very different and very interesting. Let's just check if the water is ready. Yep, almost. So by that time it is getting ready. Let me prepare the tin. We just need to take any aluminium or steel dish, take a little bit of oil and grease it nicely. The reason we have to grease it well is so that when we take the dhokla out, it should come out nice and smooth without breaking. Pour the batter and just place this dish inside the steamer. Put it on medium heat and let it cook for about 15 minutes. You don't need to stand here, you don't need to do anything. It'll just cook on its own. Let me see the dhokla. And yeah, it's risen very nicely and it looks done. It's going to be very hot, so just let it be in the steamer for about 5 to 10 minutes and then take it out. And here is the dhokla. Just try to loosen out the sides. And when it's not very hot, then cut it. Because if it's very hot and you'll cut it, it'll start sticking and it won't cut very nicely. You can cut squares, you can cut rectangles, you can cut a diamond shape, anything that you like. I'll be garnishing it with a few chopped green chilies. There you go. The upma dhokla is ready to serve.